Sounds like it. Hey, Alistair, and Alistair, I'm glad that you called in, man. Alistair is actually the head of our crypto club, so I'm sure this is going to be an in-depth, intuitive question. Alistair, what's going on? You've been unmuted. Unmute yourself.
Hey, what's going on, guys? Hey, Mike. You know, thank you for sharing your knowledge on the space. I had a question about the regulatory aspect of what's, you know, of DeFi, because DeFi is providing a lot of the same financial services that traditional finance offers, but they're doing it in a permissionless way. So do you see the traditional finance institutions preparing for it? And do you think that there is going to be a big regulatory push to lock down what we see going on in DeFi right now?
Oh, that's a great, great question. I told banks, I was up at Bank of America recently, and I told the CEO, I said, you guys were so wrong being worried about Bitcoin. I'm going to sneeze in a second. So Bitcoin was an asset that you could buy and collect, you could asset manage, you could trade, but it wasn't a threat to the banks. DeFi is coming right at you, and they know it. And so what you're going to see is a lot of FUD from the banks, a lot of pushback. They're going to try to push the regulators to try to shut DeFi down, because DeFi is going to go right at the core of their business. What is DeFi for the audience that doesn't pay attention? It's taken a blockchain, which is just a shared database, and using it to do things that banks do. Trade derivatives, trade equities, right? Sell insurance, you know, do insurance, do structured products. And it cuts out a huge amount of fat, and it allows you to trade peer-to-peer. It's a driverless bank. Pretty cool, right? There are no people. It's just code. So who can you regulate when it's just code? You can only regulate the people that use it. You can't regulate the code itself. So who's using the code? Well, I want to use the code. Right now, if you're, you know, a consumer, and the regulators could care less if you use DeFi. But if you're Galaxy or any of the institutions, we can't use it. We can invest in it, but we can't use it yet because we don't know who's on the other side of the trade. And so the big regulatory risk around DeFi is knowing your customer. It's called KYC AML, Know Your Customer Anti-Money Laundering. The moment that gets solved, and there are a lot of smart people solving it, I think DeFi is going to explode. There's going to be a trade long DeFi, short the banks. Some of the banks are trying to move fast. They just can't move fast enough. Their regulators, their size, they're going to sell crypto in their wealth channel, Bitcoin first. Then they'll start trading. They're all going to need to trade Bitcoin or crypto, because as we move to more stable coins, which we're going to, right? Just even their currency trading is going to happen in cryptos. And so mark my words, in 3 years, every 3 or 4 years, every bank will have a crypto trading desk, just like I do. But DeFi, it cuts them out. And quite frankly, listen, it's going to cut out some of Galaxy's business. We think you got to bite off your arm constantly and regrow something, right? Because it's innovating so fast. I think the tech companies are better at doing that. And that's why you see every tech company plunging into crypto, right? Mark my words, Apple's coming in soon enough.
Absolutely.
But, you know, PayPal, Venmo, Square, Tesla, you know, you saw Elon today. He said, yeah, we sold some because we want to understand the liquidity. We're buying, we're taking it from our customers. Like, you're going to see crypto permeate the world, not all at once. It'll go in little waves. But the most interesting thing to watch is your question. And it's not like the banks are going to lay down and get rolled over. They're going to fight back, and they're going to fight dirty. That's what people do in business. And so, you know, the crypto side is gearing up as well. And so you're seeing, you know, people hire ex-regulators. You're seeing, and the good thing is the regulators are getting smarter. I mean, Gary Gensler, who's the head of the SEC, he taught a class on blockchain at MIT. I was a guest professor. Guest lecture, not a professor. But I'd like to be a professor. he knows crypto. And so the old head of the SEC, Jay Clayton, he didn't want to deal with it. Just wasn't on his watch. He just didn't want to engage. Gary will engage, I'm positive. I know the guy. He will engage with crypto. You won't like every one of his rulings, but as long as the rulings are clear, it catapults the space forward.
Well, which banks do you think are most susceptible to going out of business as a result of DeFi over the next 10 years?
I don't think they go out of business right away. It's just, you know, if you think about their businesses get hurt, right? More just like they got hurt by fintech, right? Think about Robinhood, right? What are the, that was a whole new market. That should have been EF Hutton or, you know, or E-Trade, right? Robinhood came and they kind of ate part of E-Trade's lunch. E-Trade ate part of Goldman Sachs's lunch. And I think you're going to see this same thing.